It's time for the Trading Stocks Made Easy podcast. Each week, Trading Stocks Made Easy demystifies stock trading and investing so you can profit big. And now, here's the host of Trading Stocks Made Easy, the wealthy investor, Tyrone Jackson.
And welcome back to Trading Stocks Made Easy. I'm happy that you're joining me. Of course, it's Tyrone Jackson, the wealthy investor, and this is episode number 9. You know, I try to feature a lot of my students on this show to inspire you. And the one thing that I really hope that you get to see is that they are regular people just like you. Many of them have chosen the creative arts, either as an actor, writer, which is enormously difficult to survive in and make a living. But not only have the guests who are featured on this program been able to successfully pursue their careers, they've put money aside and now they're creating financial freedom for themselves as stock market traders and investors. Now, on today's show, we're going to hear from a gentleman by the name of Andre Blake, who's a successful movie actor, commercials, and voiceovers. And one of the things that we're going to talk about today is this transition from his mindset to be a successful performer to his mindset to making thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars for himself continuously in the stock market. This is an interview that you really want to pay careful attention to because it has something to do with your mindset. You should be earning thousands and thousands of dollars, even if you know nothing about how to trade and invest. Now it's time for you to get that financial education. So when we come back, our interview with actor Andre Blake.
You're listening to the Trading Stocks Made Easy podcast. Want to learn more about how to trade and invest in the stock market? Visit thewealthyinvestor.net/products. That's thewealthyinvestor.net/products and order the Wealthy Investor's Guide to Stock Market Success audio series. This easy-to-follow 5-CD audio series and manual will teach you the basics of how to buy and sell stocks, how to collect quarterly dividends for life, plus hidden income-generating strategies like covered call writing and volatility trading. Start creating financial freedom right now. Get the financial education you need to get ahead. Visit thewealthyinvestor.net/products.
And welcome back. It's time. Why don't we go and hang out with actor Andre Blake and pay careful attention to how he was raised, his expectations, and his mindset.
This is actor Andre Blake, who's going to not only be talking to us a little bit about his mindset that he uses for stock market trading, he also applies that same mindset to his professional career, which has made him very, very, very successful. So many of you will recognize Andre from many of both his movie, his television shows, and commercials. So I can't go through all of his movie credits. You know, life as a working actor is not always the easiest thing to achieve, but this is someone who's really done very, very, very well for himself, and you really want to listen to what he has to say, his thoughts and his ideas, again, as he applies that millionaire mindset to his professional life and certainly to his life as a stock market trader. You know, Andre's done so many movies, I can't even begin to go through them, but there's a wonderful picture called Who's the Man, if you remember that. He was in Philadelphia with Denzel Washington. He has this wonderful pivotal scene there. A movie called Silence of the Lambs, you may have heard of that. And that's just a few of his movies. On the TV side, he was recently on a show called The Blacklist, Madam Secretary. And Andre is also a working voiceover artist, a triple threat in many different arenas. And he is best known right now as the voice of BET. Big deal. Did I tell you this guy was a big fish or what? He's also simultaneously one of the voices of Subway Sandwiches and AT&T. And I could go on and on and on, but I have to stop now because I have to welcome Andre Blake to the show. Andre, welcome.
Thanks for having me, Tyrone. Thank you so much.
Boy,
really appreciate it.
Oh, are you kidding me? It is truly, truly my pleasure to have you here. You are so successful both in the TV side of things, the movie, and really the voiceover side. I mean, I couldn't say those things if it just wasn't true. And to see how you work as an actor, but yet take your trading in the stock market equally as serious is a wonderful, wonderful thing.
Yes, sir.
So let's get right into, because, you know, they say success has 1,000 fathers and failure is an orphan. So you have a lot of success, and I want to go step by step right before we get into the stock market. You actually came from a family where your mother was in the movie business, correct?
Yes, this is very true. My mother is actually from Venezuela, and she came to the States as a young girl looking to, you know, do better for herself and her family, one of 12, who would work here and send money back to help support her family. And she got really lucky early in that she was working for a bigwig over at the William Morris Agency. She was an executive secretary and made herself very useful, so much so that this big executive would sign whatever she put in front of him. And so one day she put some paperwork in front of him to sign, and it was actually paperwork for her to join a film union called Local 161, and that's how she got into the business. A little ingenuity, yeah, and a little bit of got to make it happen.
So got to make it happen. Right. Yes, and your mother's very lovely, very driven, and quite accomplished in her own right.
Tell us
a little bit about your father, who's also very intelligent and also very successful. What's his background?
My father is actually from Trinidad. I was born in Trinidad in the West Indies, actually. And my father is one of the smartest people I know. He's actually an engineer and ran an airline, British West Indian Airways. So he was the hometown boy who came to the States, studied hard, went to Columbia, went to Howard, and got his degrees and worked his way up and became vice president of this little airline, British West Indian Airways. And so excellence has always, I guess, been a part of my upbringing, if you will. Yeah.
Well, boy, is it a part of your upbringing, because it reflects itself in your professional life. Just before we get into, I want to make the jump. I want to start off with how you grew up, and then I want to start off with what mindset you apply to your show business career, and then into the stock market. Now, did you grow up in Long Island, New York?
I grew up on Long Island, New York, in Hempstead. Okay. I'm one of three, two older sisters who are both very, very brilliant in their own rights. I have one sister who's a professor at NYU. My other sister's a teacher in Manhattan, actually. So I remember distinctly growing up, you know, when you come from a West Indian household, it's you will do well, period. There is no other way. And if you think otherwise, then, you know, we will help you change your thinking.
Right.
You know, one way or another. But, my parents worked very hard, so they instilled hard work in all of in their children, my siblings and I. And I remember watching my mother work on these film sets, and she was always very organized. I was like, wow, everything had its place. And she instilled that in us as kids. Everything has its place. If you know where something is, when somebody asks you for it, you know, you can put your hand on it. So just organize yourself, whether it be alphabetically or chronologically, and just, you know, stay on top of your stuff. And that's proven very, very helpful for me in all phases of my life. Organization is key.
So you feel, to some extent, that you were primed or programmed for success. Would that be a fair assessment?
Sure. Primed, sure. Scared into success, sure.
Scared. not many people can say they were scared and were frightened into success.
It's like, y'all better not fail.
Right. Now, one of the things that's really fascinating is being primed for success. There's a point in your life where you mentioned to your father, I think I'm going to be an actor. And he was less than thrilled about that. Is that correct?
Yes, actually.
Okay.
And I remember that night distinctly because we were sitting around dinner and, you know, we were going around the table, well, who wants to be what when they grow up? And my eldest sister said, well, I'm going to be a dancer. And my West Indian father in his West Indian accent said, you know, what you going to do with that? You gotta make money with that. So It got to my other sister, who said, well, I'm going to be a doctor. And then I thought about saying, I'm going to be a doctor or something of that sort. But I knew that wasn't true. And, the one thing that my parents definitely always instilled in us was integrity. And my mother always said, to me, you can do and be whatever you want to be. Okay? Just work hard and try to be the best. That's it. So I was like, okay. So I remember at that dinner, and I swallowed real hard and had some water, and, you know, I think I want to be an actor. Oh, no, not you, too. You know, so have their oldest daughter and their youngest son running towards the arts.
Okay, so you announce that you're going to be an actor, you get an agent, you start to get acting jobs, and somewhere along the line, you discover the stock market. Can you remember when that was?
Yes, I remember very crystal clear when that was. I was living in California. I tell this joke to people sometimes, in that in around 1999, 2000, right around there sometime, I was up for a TV show, a little TV show called Special Victims Unit. And Dick Wolf, the creator of the show, wanted me for this character, and the network wanted a name. So that's how you get Ice-T.
Right.
So to say that I was hurt was an understatement.
Right.
So I decided I'm going to go to California and I'm going to make this acting thing work. So I packed up my little life. I grabbed all that I had saved from doing my voiceover gigs and commercials and this and that, and it amounted to a nice amount of money. I went out to California, came back in 2005, broke with two kids.
Right.
And so I said to myself, I got to do
something. Hold on, just for clarification, it's not that you picked up someone else's kids. You were in a relationship.
No.
It's not like you found two kids and you said, hey, come back to New York with me.
On the streets. Come on.
Okay.
Come on, let's hang out. No, I was blessed with two children. And so decided to come back to New York and ran into a friend of mine, one Mr. Tyrone Jackson.
Yes, sir.
And he said to me, you know, I'm thinking about starting this thing. And I said, what are you going to do? He said, I think I want to teach performers how to trade their money in the stock market for income.
Yes.
Well, that's all I needed to hear. Because at that time, all I had was my dreams and a little bit of savings left and, you know, and two children who I knew I had to support. So anything that could help me support my family, I was up for. And I remember saying to you, I'm in. And the financial education that I've received from you, sir, has been, it's changed my life. So thank you.
Yes. Listen, it's truly my pleasure. You know, it really has changed your life in a major way. And we've talked about this, you know, privately, what it's going to do for your kids. Because, you know, part of getting a financial education, learning how to invest, we pass that knowledge on to our children. Okay,
yes,
so let's get into, you've been trading successfully in the stock market now for how many years has it been?
At least about 7 years.
At least 7 years. I know you know a lot, so we got to try to keep it simple because the name of the show is Trading Stocks Made Easy, and you have a lot of experience under your belt. So if you can think back, obviously, first trade, I say this to everyone who comes on the show, first trade is cover call writing. Can you remember the first time you wrote a cover call to bring in that guaranteed income against the stock that you own? Do you recall that?
You know, in all honesty, I don't remember the first cover call that I wrote. But I do remember the feeling that, oh my gosh, I just clicked my mouse and my money made money that I did not have to go out and work for, that I didn't have to sign contracts for, I didn't have to wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning and drive an hour and a half to some strange location to then sit in a chair for an hour while they do makeup and all this other stuff, and then get rushed to this. There was none of that.
Right.
It literally took me maybe 5 minutes to execute the trade. Maybe.
Yes.
And my money made money. And I thought to myself, I'm going to be rich.
More with my interview of Andre Blake back in a moment.
You're listening to the Trading Stocks Made Easy podcast. Want to learn more about how to trade and invest in the stock market? Visit thewealthyinvestor.net/products. That's thewealthyinvestor.net/products. And order the Wealthy Investor's Guide to Stock Market Success audio series. This easy-to-follow 5-CD audio series and manual will teach you the basics of how to buy and sell stocks, how to collect quarterly dividends for life, plus hidden income-generating strategies like covered call writing and volatility trading. Start creating financial freedom right now. Get the financial education you need to get ahead. Visit thewealthyinvestor.net/products.
And we're back from commercial. Thank you for joining us. Yes, please visit thewealthyinvestor.net. It's really important that you order, actually, the Wealthy Investor's Guide to Stock Market Success. That CD series is so important because most people are intimidated by the stock market. It's a great way for you to learn the language and many of the strategies that my guests actually talk about. So please go to thewealthyinvestor.net/products and make sure you get your copy of the Wealthy Investor's Guide to Stock Market Success. Now, back to our interview with actor Andre Blake.
Now, we're going to talk about this realization when you were like, I could be rich doing this. But right before we get into the mechanics of the trade, because I always say when you click that mount, when you buy a stock and you sell that call and you make guaranteed instant money, something has to shift in your mindset. And in the Wealthy Investor Program, we refer to that as your millionaire mindset because it can literally make you millions. Where was a shift in your consciousness, in your belief, so that you even got to the point where you could put money in a brokerage account and try this trade? What happened for you mentally and emotionally right before that?
For me, the idea, you know, you got to understand something. I came from hardworking folks. You go to college, you work hard, you show up on your job and all that stuff. And that's how it works. You work hard, somebody gives you a paycheck. And what clicked for me was that I thought to myself as I was executing the trade, this isn't hard.
Right.
And it kind of went against how I was programmed, how I was socialized to believe making money was supposed to be this hard thing. You had to go out and by the sweat of your brow and walk for miles and all of these things. And I had to remind myself, wait a minute, we live in a technological age whereby this little computer that I have in front of me, you can literally run an empire from your desk. That changed everything for me. It changed everything.
Even though, and this is what's so interesting, you were already making residual income as a commercial actor. But this was another door that was open when you saw that you could do it by logging into your online trading account, right?
Living and working as an actor, you come to understand residual income. The thought that I could control my money to perform as a residual instrument for myself, it tweaked all of my thinking about everything. There was a shift in that I now saw opportunities where I didn't see them before, even though they were right in front of my face before. But the idea of the stock market, this place that exists where I can go and buy and sell things, was beyond me. I was never taught that in school. My parents didn't know. My parents didn't know about this. I introduced my father to the stock market after being in your program, and he's taken to it like a duck to water. And I believe it's added years to my dad's life.
Right.
Because when people see and feel the power in trading, in covered call writing, in options trading, and some of the more advanced things that you teach in the program, it's almost impossible for you to be the same. It's as if someone has drawn this curtain back and you now see the machine and how it works. And these light bulbs and possibilities go off in your head on a regular basis. Pretty amazing.
It is amazing. Now, the other side of this story, and please share just a little bit about this, is you said you mentioned it to your father, and he's now a trader, right?
Yes.
And he makes money in the stock market. But you also took it to your friendship base, and you didn't get the same response from everyone.
Mm-hmm.
What did you discover when you said, hey, there's this stock market, this is a great way to make money, and I want you to all participate in it? What were the responses that you encountered more often than not?
Oh, be careful. You're going to lose all your money.
Okay.
That's for rich people. Like, it's for everybody. What I really came to understand is that we as a people, as a society, are so undereducated where finance is concerned. You know, listen, I'm all for higher education and people going to college and learning. And I believe what the university system is about, it more teaches you how to deal with other people from different places and different walks of life. And it's not always about what's in the book, because you have to learn to get along. So that being said, if I can help someone to better their financial lot in life, you know, and And it was, what was interesting was the resistance that I got was from people who know me. I mean, like, know me and love me and respect me. And I've shared meals with them at their homes and all of that stuff. And you bring things up. And I guess some people are open and some are closed. And I found more often than not, and especially even family members, were closed. They're just completely closed to the idea. They had to fight all of the old things that they were taught about money and how money works and who money is for. I think there was some type of, for a lot of folks, there's a subconscious block, but there's a fear about the stock market, I believe, for a lot of people. Because, you know, you're told that's only for rich people. That's only for, you know, oh my gosh, the Dow Jones, and what is that? What's an annuity? What's a stock? What's a covered? What's that? And you're putting your stuff at risk. And you can hear people when you start having the conversation about finances. I've actually heard people talk themselves out of the possibility of being financially free.
That is correct. It does seem that we can get into some sort of comfort zone of just having enough money, just having enough to get by. And if everyone around you is sharing that same belief system, as we get older, it's harder to step out of that and say, hey, maybe my life was meant to have something different. Maybe there's a different reality, a different purpose for me financially.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so for you and a few of your friends actually join you in this effort, and they learn how to trade.
Mm-hmm.
And I can remember one friend in particular, he was really talented at it. Actually, he's a very successful musician. We won't say his name, but he was very, very good at it. But you continue to trade. You continue to study. It's a part of your lifestyle.
Yes.
And let's talk about, if I were to ask you off the top of your head, and I know you have a lot of experience now, but what are your three favorite trades and why?
My three favorite would have to be covered calls, obviously,
because it's
guaranteed income. I buy the stock, I sell the call, money's in my account in a day, you know, for me to do with whatever I want. If I need to pull it out, I can pull it out. If I want to leave it, I leave it. You know, I like to reinvest it and turn those profits into dividends, but that's just me. I really like, and I know this is more advanced, I'm not going to get into it, but trading leap options, volatility trading.
Yes.
And spreads, but that's a whole other conversation. Yeah.
Yes, it is. Okay, now, I know that you've done some interesting things with your profits. You've paid for things. Just share with our audience maybe two things you've done in the past 2 or 3 years, specifically with the money that you've made from the stock market. I know there's been some vacations, right?
Yes.
And a few other things.
It's funny, I'm looking at it on my wrist right now. There was this watch. Oh, my gosh, I can't believe I'm going to say this. There was this watch that I saw years ago that I really, really wanted. And I waited and I waited and I waited. And I thought to myself, you know what, Andre? You deserve it. So why don't you take this money that you're going to make from writing these covered calls this month and put that towards your watch? And I did, and I actually used all of it, and it covered all of the watch, and every time I look at my wrist, it's a reminder that, you know, through the stock market, all things are possible.
Right, they are. And so we've got a watch, we've got vacations, like an automobile.
What's the name of that place, this little place in the Bahamas? Oh, right, Atlantis, yeah. I took my kids to Atlantis, courtesy of the stock market. Yeah,
and isn't it a great idea? Because, you know, I took my daughters to Maui, and while we were in Maui, I did a couple of trades, and that paid for the food the next day. And I said, you guys realize you're having like a cover call lunch? And of course, they're so tired of me talking about the stock market. They're like, yes, we get it. Yes, 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 yes.
Yeah, Dad, we get it.
Right, we get it. You make money in the stock market, and you're the teacher, and we're all going to be rich. We understand that. So you like cover calls, you like spreads. Do you find that, because this is one of the things that I do teach, is that sometimes people start making money trading, using these first simple trades, and then we get into complex trades. Do you find that the idea, you talk about a feeling a little while, is that this money never runs out? Like, these trades are there to do tomorrow, and they'll be there next week and the week after that. What does that
do for
you and the rest of your life? What does that do for you? Does that bring you comfort?
It brings me a level of comfort and reassurance that I can't really verbalize. I started my brokerage account, and I have no problem telling people this, with right around $2,000, which isn't a lot. I scraped and I saved, and I had enough, and the program started, and I was like, I'm going to do this. And so some of it, I guess, was in my determination to find a way to provide, to find a way to have a better life, because that's what I wanted for myself. And that was the one thing that I always knew, was that I could find a way to do whatever it is that I needed to do and make it happen. Find a way.
Find a way to make it happen. And that's exactly what Andre Blake has continued to do. And that's why he's so successful. And that's what I want you to do. I want you to be inspired to take action and take your financial life to the next level. Hey, that's all the time that we have for this particular episode. This is Tyrone Jackson saying thank you so much for listening to Trading Stocks Made Easy. And visit us on iTunes and make sure you subscribe, rate, and review this show if you got something that's really wonderful out of it. I'll see you next time. And until then, I wish you trading success and a millionaire mindset.
You've been listening to the Trading Stocks Made Easy podcast. Be sure to rate and review our show on iTunes. While you're on iTunes, be sure to click the subscribe button and you'll automatically receive our next episode.